SpaceX is preparing for a flight that will likely occur in a few days. Most of the work has been completed, but SpaceX still has several important tasks to complete in the coming days. Everyone is hoping for a successful flight that will have a major impact on the space race. So, how are they preparing for Flight 10? What's next for SpaceX? Why is Flight 10 so important? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. SpaceX has achieved another major goal as it prepares for the exciting Flight 10. The company just completed the final spin prime test with spacecraft 37. This is a crucial step before preparing for launch. The test went well for the second time. SpaceX quickly identified and fixed the issue that ended the first attempt early. With this achievement, SpaceX is now ready to move on to the next step in preparing for flight. Following their success, SpaceX began moving items around Starbase. Once the transport landing pad arrived and the spacecraft was lowered, spacecraft 37 was lifted from the landing pad and carefully placed on the launch pad. Shortly afterward, as scheduled, the spacecraft was brought back to Mega Bay 2. While much has happened behind the doors of the large bay, it's easy to guess what will happen next. The first priority will be a series of detailed inspections. All systems on SpaceX 37 will be thoroughly inspected to ensure they are fully prepared. One of the most important things to be checked is the engines. Although the engines weren't fired in the final test, the spacecraft still underwent a spin prime test. This means that cryogenic fuel flowed through its systems. This exposure means engineers need to ensure all components are safe and functioning properly for the next flight. The performance of the engines will be crucial. They must perform well during launch, function flawlessly in space, and help the spacecraft find its way back for a safe landing. The heat shield is another crucial system under scrutiny. Observers have noted that the heat shield is not yet in its final form. This may mean engineers will add or remove tiles in some places. This system is crucial for SpaceX 10, as it will have to handle the intense heat and pressure of re-entry. SpaceX plans to experiment with various designs for the heat shield. This includes sections with missing tiles and new metal tiles. This testing will provide important information for future flights. Inside spacecraft 37, engineers will inspect the composite pressure vessel and fuel tank. These components will need to be inspected to ensure there are no leaks or damage that could impact the mission. They will also focus on the flaps, especially the rear one, as they are worn from previous missions. The joints in this area may require additional support to ensure proper re-entry and landing performance. Once the inspection is complete, we will begin installation work. The payloads must be assembled immediately, as the Starlink payload box has been shipped to Mega Bay 2 before being shipped back to the Star Factory for storage.
It can be brought back whenever S-37 is ready. Another key system is the Flight Termination System, which must be prepared before launch. Overall, this task shouldn't take too long considering how quickly we're working. We can expect Ship 37 to be ready around August 25th. At that time, the vehicle will go to the launch pad for the third time, this time for actual flight. Meanwhile, important changes are taking place on the launch pad. Unexpectedly, the test stand was lowered after S-37 was completed and will not be used for S-38 testing. Instead, a crane will be used to remove the test stand from the launch pad. The ship's quick disconnect pipe and associated systems will likely be removed soon to install the booster's quick disconnect system. Once completed, the retaining clamp arms will be reinstalled, preparing the pad for booster operations again. This task should only take a few days. Next, the focus will shift to B-16, which is preparing to be moved from the rocket park to the launch pad for final preparations. The rocket launcher has completed hot staging tests and has been equipped with the FTS, bringing it closer to launch. In the meantime, B-16 has also been thoroughly inspected. Engineers are checking the structure to ensure it can handle the high angles of attack expected during descent and landing. They're also focusing on the engines. They need to manage multiple shutdowns and restarts, and they also need to demonstrate improved reliability after the Flight 9 rocket launcher experienced an engine failure that caused it to disintegrate near the landing area. For added safety, B-16 will attempt to land using two internal engines. This way, if one engine fails, there's a backup. With S-37 and B-16 nearing completion, we'll likely have a complete stack by the end of August. If all goes according to plan, the two stages could be assembled as soon as August 25th. This means they could be ready for launch by the end of August, as August 27th is exactly 3 months after the Flight 9 mission. That's a date to keep in mind for a potential launch. What do you think? Will SpaceX launch by the end of this month? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Also, please like the video and subscribe to our channel to keep up with SpaceX's incredible progress. Beyond the visible hardware work, SpaceX has also overcome another major challenge on the road to Flight 10. That crucial step is obtaining a license. After Flight 9 concluded, many noticed that the Federal Aviation Administration hadn't shared much information about Starship. This included updates on the latest accident investigation and what SpaceX needed to fix. The lack of clear communication made it unclear how long approvals would take. Good news, recent updates have helped clarify things.
The FAA has announced that the investigation into the Flight 9 problem is finished. This means that SpaceX has been officially approved to go ahead with Flight 10. This is an important step that helps the company progress without any delays from regulations. The improvement in teamwork between SpaceX and the FAA is particularly impressive when compared to earlier flights. The process is now quicker and more effective, indicating that both sides are collaborating well to keep the program on track. By simplifying communication and fixing problems faster, they are reducing delays and helping SpaceX plan better for future launches. Now that SpaceX has the necessary licenses, it can focus entirely on getting the hardware ready for launch. The company aims to finish by August 24th and will keep working nonstop until the vehicle is ready. But getting the FAA's approval is just one part of the whole process. More steps are needed, such as getting the closure times for the coast from Starbase City and Cameron County, hazard warnings from maritime agencies for landing areas, and planning for flight tracking aircraft. All these things need to happen before we can take off. Getting approval for the launch is just as important as getting the vehicle and launching setup ready. It's an important point that makes sure the way to take off stays open. Keep watching our channel for important updates as SpaceX approaches its big Flight 10. How important is Flight 10 for SpaceX? To find out, we need to take a step back and check the current progress of the Starship program. A few months ago, people were wondering if this would be the first mission to try to catch the ship using the launch tower's chopsticks. That hope is put aside now because SpaceX has said they won't try to catch it on this flight, making it less important. This makes Flight 10 even more important. The truth is that after three difficult flights in 2025, SpaceX really needs a successful mission. Success here isn't just a symbolic win. It is the basis for rebuilding trust after a time of challenges and slower progress than we hoped for. Investors, partners, NASA, and even competitors are paying close attention. Flight 10 needs to prove that SpaceX has learned from past flights and is ready to move forward confidently. The result of this flight will affect when the next important tasks will happen. If Flight 10 goes well, then Flight 11 might really be the first try to catch a returning ship. This would prepare for the arrival of the new V3 version of Starship, with Flight 12 starting a new chapter for the program. But if Flight 10 fails, everything in the plan changes. Flight 11 will probably go back to a safer ocean landing. The attempt to catch it will be delayed until at least Flight 13. Since Flight 12 will showcase the new V3 hardware, SpaceX probably won't take any chances with such an important first mission.
Under these circumstances, the first opportunity to attempt to capture the spacecraft is next year. This aligns with Musk's cautious comments that capture might happen this year, but it's more likely to happen in early 2026. This delay would impact the entire Starship development plan. Being able to capture the spacecraft safely and orderly is crucial, not just for technical reasons. It's a way to achieve the program's larger goals. If you don't learn how to recover properly, building an orbital refueling system will be more difficult and time-consuming. That system is crucial for nearly every exciting Starship mission to come. SpaceX has big plans, like launching multiple satellites and exploring deep space. They aim to send an uncrewed mission to Mars by the end of 2026. Furthermore, NASA's Artemis 3 moon landing in 2027 requires Starship to refuel in space. To stay on schedule, we need to validate most of the refueling system by mid-2026. Any delay makes an already tight schedule even tighter. Flight 10 isn't just another test, it's a critical time for SpaceX. Competition is fierce. ULA's Vulcan is now operational. Blue Origin's New Glenn rocket has reached orbit, and the next launch is scheduled for September. Rocket Lab's Neutron is preparing for its maiden flight. Meanwhile, Chinese companies are trying to copy the Starship design. To stay ahead, SpaceX needs to demonstrate that Starship is reliable and ready for refueling, capture, and Artemis missions. Winning will maintain momentum, but losing will give competitors a chance to catch up. We're getting closer to one of Starship's biggest flights yet. How it plays out will impact the future of SpaceX and the entire race for space exploration. SpaceX and the industry are busy preparing rockets and ground systems. That's it for today's episode, and we'll see you next time.